the sunroof. I'm blasting our favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes in your head. You know it.
What's up, you guys? It is your favorite girl, Yana, and I'm back with the next episode with The Talk. So first, I just want to say I hope everything is going well with you guys. I hope everybody is being saved. I hope y'all healthy, everything. I just be trying to give y'all words of encouragement, like I always say. Today is Thursday or whatever, and I really didn't do much this week, did I? I really didn't. Really just been like out the way a little bit in my own little world, doing my own little motion, having my own little thing going. But yeah, I'm excited to talk to y'all and we're gonna get straight into it. The first thing I want to talk about was actor Drake Bell. He was reported missing and in danger in Daytona Beach. And he was traveling, y'all, in a 2022 gray BMW, and his last known potentially whereabouts were near Mainline High School on Wednesday at 9 p.m. But I checked again like 5 minutes before I started to do the podcast or whatever, and I saw that he was found. So that's good news or whatever. Y'all, I also want to talk about, y'all remember the Shanquella Robinson case? The girl who went out of town with her friends out of the country or whatever and they killed her. So why the U.S. officials will not pursue criminal charges when it comes to her death. And that was like a press conference and it was held with her family and the attorney or whatever. And they shared an autopsy was performed in Charlotte and it revealed that her spine was still intact. I just really don't get that whole situation. I really feel like the people, she was there with her friends and she's the only one that died. She's the only one that didn't come back. I feel like charges should be pursued. Like, what? Charges are dropped. Really doesn't make sense to me. But yeah, the autopsy of her case is undermined. But like they said, that was the most significant findings. And it was something like with her forehead. She had a concussion, brain injury. So I just feel like, why they not in jail? You know what I'm saying? I don't get it. But y'all already know the queen of rap in my eyes. Y'all already know it's Queen Latifah. So she was added to the National Recording Registry. So she's making history, baby. They announced it with Queen Latifah's album from 1989, All Hail the Queen. Mm-hmm, she's joining the recording registry. So shout out to my girl. The registry, like, collects audio treasures worthy of preservation from all time based on their cultural, historical, and aesthetic. And y'all know Queen Latifah most definitely have her own aesthetic, and it's very pretty. Like, Queen Latifah is very attractive. Yeah, most people wouldn't even say that, but Queen Latifah is beautiful. But yeah, so let's give a congratulations to my girl, Queen Latifah. Black Queens Matter. Black Lives Matter. The Americans who survived kidnapping in Mexico speak out about their terrifying incident. Last month, it was like 4 Americans were kidnapped by the cartel while in Mexico, and their kidnapping was caught on video. So, unfortunately, 2 of the 4 Americans were killed during this incident. Now, 2 survivors, I think her name was Latavia Washington McGee and Eric Williams, you know, they speak out with Anderson Cooper about the terrifying experience. That's crazy. First of all, these people are grown and they were kidnapped by a cartel and 2 people died. No, 3 people died. 2 or 4 people died. And it's 2 survivors left, Black African Americans. That's crazy. That's scary. But I definitely have to tap in because I definitely want to hear about that. I know y'all remember seeing about the 12-year-old girl who stole her dad's car and drove 400 miles to meet a friend online. This girl drove across state borders in a vehicle. And the people were allegedly traveling. It was 2 of them. I think someone was wearing, like I said, they were traveling to meet someone online. So on Thursday morning, it was like a missing child alert was sent across several states for a 12-year-old and a 14-year-old girl after they disappeared from their hometown in Lake Butler, Florida. It has not been revealed if the minors were on their way to visit an adult. They reportedly turned themselves into the authorities after seeing themselves on TV at a gas station in Alabama. Authorities say there are some suspicions circumstances and red flags involved in their disappearing and the person they met online. So the case is now being turned over to the FBI for further investigation. But 12, 14, was I driving then? I don't think I was driving then. I think I started to driving. I'm not going to say I didn't know how, but I think my mama just, you know, she wasn't playing with me, letting me get her car. I think I started driving in 2018, and I only started driving because my mama was pregnant with my brother. And you know how it is, them 6 weeks, they can't go outside. But, yeah, that's scary. Y'all should watch y'all kids. And that's why I be saying, like, it's heavy on age limits with certain things that they do online. But it's just like, kids are smart. Technology is advancing, but it's like it's really nothing to access the internet, because me personally, I'm a person that I am very good with the internet, very good with using a computer and my phone. When I want to find something, I can find something. When I'm trying to do, I can multitask and I can handle that computer. I most definitely can do that. So I know a little child can. 12 and 14, yeah. It's another case like that. A Georgia mom seeks answers after her child is mysteriously burned at daycare, Black, of course. But I think her name was Faya. I don't want to pronounce it wrong. But she picked up her 6-month-old daughter, Ava, from a child care network daycare in McDonough. I don't know if that's right, but it's in Georgia. But anywho, she was in shock when she noticed her child had second degree burns and a burn that she claims a daycare employee tried to pass off as a rash. We know the difference between a burn and a rash. So now the police is, of course, investigating the incident to try to figure out what exactly happened. And the Georgia Department of Early Care and Learning Network has been fined at least twice since 2018. And at least one of those times involved failure to report an incident. So look, with little information being provided and limited surveillance footage, what happened to the girl? That is a mystery and we want to know. 6-month-old baby. And y'all need to be careful and mindful what y'all say on the internet, because y'all was bashing my girl Ariana Grande. Well, not just bashing her, but y'all just was so all in her business trying to see if she was sick. And it's like, I think Ariana is 29. And y'all know people of a different race, they look different from us Black people when we do age. So it's like, y'all have to take in mind. Y'all do need to be considerate about what you're saying. You know, wishing medical problems on somebody or health problems on somebody who's not even sick. Like they said, y'all did the same thing to Chad. Y'all judged him not knowing that he had cancer and later on died. So it's just like, be mindful of what y'all say to people. Because even when you are trying to be nice and be considerate and helpful, it's like a certain way that you approach somebody, and it's a certain way you say things, and it's a celebrity. So y'all was just eating her up in the comments. Oh, you're sick. Oh, Ariana this. Oh, Ariana's that. Oh, no, she's in perfect health. Like, all of it is still rude. So just be mindful what y'all say, like she said. Just like with this incident with Armand and Reginae, y'all don't know if they broke up or not. Y'all just take some and run with it. Like, he made a tweet, and he was like, before you regret anything, remember at one time it was exactly what you wanted. That quote does not give you a hint that him and Reginae is no longer together. It's like, y'all just take things and roll with it. Y'all come up with these scenarios in y'all head and y'all believe it. Delusional. And I'm starting to believe all y'all crazy. All y'all starting to believe the same freaking thing. And it don't even be true. Y'all already know I can't forget to do my word of the day and my question of the day. So first, I think I'm going to do the question of the day. So it is, what movie or show you keep rewatching? I'm not going to cap y'all. I love to watch Vampire Diaries, either Vampire Diaries, the originals, or Legacies, because I have this like fantasy with vampires. Like, why couldn't I be a vampire? Like, I would love to compel people to do whatever I want them to do. I would love to read minds. I would love to be faster. I would love to be stronger. I don't want to die, but I know we all have to die. But like, Vampire Diaries, number one, I can watch it anytime. And I'm so mad they took it off Netflix, because what are you doing? I need to see if the original is still on Netflix, because I just might watch it again, because Klaus Mikkelsen. Yes, I really feel like I could have been married to Klaus Mikkelsen or Davina Clare or Bonnie Bennett. Or yes, like, I love the whole show. My word of the day, the glow of one warm thought is more worth than money. Yeah, the glow of one warm thought is, to me, worth more than money. And I can get that, because money, they be like, money can't buy you happiness. Money can most definitely buy you happiness. If I could buy me a BMW right now, I would be happy. If I could be rich right now, I would be happier. because I won't have to worry about certain things. But I'm not gonna cap. I take in like what I'm trying to say. Like, I just live in the moment, so it's just like warm thought is most definitely worth more than money to me, because I'm not gonna cap, happiness and peace is all I'm craving right now, and money do bring problems. It does bring problems. So, that's a nice little quote, but you know, it throw me in the loop. But I'm gonna wrap it up for you guys, and I pray y'all have a safe weekend, and hug on to your loved ones, the ones that you love the most. I'm not even gonna say the ones that you love the most. Just get closer to your family. Get closer to the people that mean something to you, important people in your life. You know what I'm saying? Just get closer to them. Tell them you love them. Hug them more. Be around them more. Enjoy life with them more. Live in the moment more. Because at the end of the day, you're a spirit and you're nothing but energy, just having a human experience. So I pray everyone have a safe and blessed weekend. And yeah, y'all stay out my way, because I might rant. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to rant y'all over. But I love y'all. Be safe. And check me out Wednesday at 4 p.m. I will be live from 91.7 on my radio show. And let's just say y'all be throwing out them hits. Like, next week, we're going to have a good show, because I couldn't do my show this week due to family emergencies. But next week, I will be back. And yeah, I love y'all. Be safe.
My head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes in your head. You know it. You got me dancing in my bed, so let me show it. You are exactly what I want. Kinda cool and kinda not. Wanna give myself to you. Yeah, we're driving down the freeway at night. I only got one thing in the back of my mind. I'm feeling like this might be my time to shine. With you, with you, with you. I got my head out this song.